Hi, Tech Rabbit here again. So now we're going to continue the MMU2S build, and this is part 2 of pulley body assembly. Couldn't put a card for part 1. And we are in step 19, selector front plate assembly. So let's get into that. Move some of the parts to the side we don't need. And those two screws we need. And those we don't need. So let's see now. So we can view it like this. And then we need to put this. Place the selector front plate as in the pitch note that is flat on angle edge on the printed part. The angled edge should point towards the center of the selector bodies. I have to look at the bigger picture. It's a good thing I did, because then I would have misunderstood. What's the mean like this then? So like that. Yeah, that looks like the screw holes are gonna line up correctly at least. Goes in there, goes in there. Screwdriver. So, looks like that. So that was step 19, step 20, and now we're going to be putting a blade in. So this we have to be a bit careful with. I don't know if I can see through the glass. Well, it's got blades in there. So that's what we're going to be putting in. I think you get one's going to be installed and the other one's a spare. Now there are two blades in the kit, the other are spare. So then we need that one, and then we need two screws. And it's supposed to go in this one. Okay, what way around are we? Okay. Aha, okay, this way around. And there should be a recession on this side. It's not a very clear one, that's for sure. Okay, and then we're supposed to identify it. And we're supposed to put the blade in it. Okay, well, here goes nothing. Not easy to see. So like the sharp edge. Oh, that is not. That recession is not very clear. Alright. Oh, this is gonna slip all over the place. Get a bit of pressure on it. Don't cut yourself. I'm talking to myself. Okay, so... Oh, I don't know if I can even show it. So, the blade should be extruding into this area approximately like that, with a sharp slanting section like down like that, according to the main pitch. So I think that looks kind of like the way it should be. Oy. Now I just... Ah, now it moved. Oh, well, now it's actually more correct according to what the picture would indicate. So I'm just going to hold it here and screw it in place before it slips again. Okay, something like that then. Trying to show it so you can see how the blades orient. Not that easy. And it does look like it's coming at an edge out there. Well, that's according to the picture, at least, as far as I can tell. And it's tightened down now, and it has a blade in it, so we need to be careful so we don't cut ourselves. So that was step 21. And now we have 22. We need to take this one back. Like that. And then this should like sit sort of here somehow. Like that. Whoop. Let's pull them out. Okay. Keep it on the edge. And then we are supposed to put these rods through. Or what? No. Put it through the right holes. The holes are in the center, not at the side. At the bottom also. Oh, that's a bit tighter. Oh, it's very tight at the bottom. Aye. Okay, so the top one seems to want to go in nicely, so we handle that one first, and it slips in there nicely. And the bottom one is definitely not wanting to cooperate. Okay, I'm just gonna have to work on so the top one went in fine, that just slips in, so that's not an issue. But the bottom one is not wanting to cooperate. Okay, I had to push quite hard, but it actually went in okay. So that one's fixed. And then what are we supposed to do? Final check, move the selector back and forth along the entire length of the smooth rods to ensure the blade isn't colliding with printed parts. Okay. No. feels fine. Oh, don't think that's an issue. Next one. Motor, check the thread on the shaft and... check the thread on the shaft and make sure there's no plastic on it. No, can't see. So now it's in the orientation. Oh, this cap's on slipping out. The top one is very loose. Okay, so then we need to make sure. Okay, and we just rotate it in. I'm not putting the cables. So that's like that. Okay, now we need to put it in with three screws. Okay, so they will be... So I'll just get this fixed. The one in there. One in there, and then one. Oh. Can one see it? There. So, that's the screws put in. I'm trying to learn how to show, like, the camera's like the wrong way. So there, there, and there. And it's actually quite hard to learn how to show things from a wrong orientation. Okay, so that's looking pretty massive. I don't know why we had to check for plastic on the thread of that. But, okay, and then we need to put in the sensor, which is this one here. And for that, we need that. Steel ball and the remaining screw, and then we're supposed to do some weird stuff. Where? Okay. Totally misunderstanding. No, okay, sorry, I'm just misunderstanding the picture. It meant that it's in the picture. Yeah, this is like that in the picture, and then I was wondering where the hole is to put the bearing. So, anyway, you're supposed to put the bearing down this hole. Push the ball bearing and select the finder circle open. Carefully screw in the pin the sensor rack and wrapping the cable as in the picture to avoid damaging it. And what do you mean by wrapping the cable? Okay. Except for the fin descent will be set in the next step. For now, let it about 6 to 7 millimeters off the threaded part above the joint printed part. Ensure fasten the pitch tightened very lightly. So we throw it in there, and then that's already crumped up. And then you didn't need to. Okay, 6 to 7 millimeters, something like that. Probably be good enough of the thread. And it's going to be adjusted later, so then we put the screw in place to hold the sensor. Shouldn't tighten it too much, just a little tiny bit. Okay, and then we're going to do some adjustment. And for that we need some filament. And then this is a bit tricky, so if I just loosen the screw up, whatever, put filament in there, push it down, pull it up, I need to make sure this goes in enough. Passes the ball. Yeah, that's definitely passing the ball. And then, I mean, mine moves up and down. I don't need to screw it. So, okay. And then you're supposed to drop it down until turn the sensor counterclockwise 90 degrees. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do then with the sensor touching the ball and this filament, and then I'm going to turn 90 degrees then, and then the final tighten. Okay, something like that. So I hope it's adjusted. Done. Step 27. Gather some more parts. So, two bearings, two axle ports, or pegs, and then two screws. And then we're gonna see what we do with those. Orientation is everything, so we put it the same way it happens in the picture. Like that. Ah, okay, it's not that complicated. We're supposed to put a bearing on each side. Get it aligned and pressed in. Bring it over to the table, I think. Oh! this thing is getting seriously heavy. Well, looks like I succeeded. I'm pressing it in. Not wrecking anything. Okay. And then next up. Oh, that was okay. 28 and 29 was just putting the bearings in, and then 30. Just to try and understand how to put this one together with this one. Somehow. So these should be coming together like that, I think. Okay, so we're supposed to actually put it on top. Something like... That's a rattly setup. Okay, and then... Okay, on the two motor side, we're supposed to put the first peg. So, we'll see. I thought that was going to be difficult, but no, it actually went in. For me, it just slided in. I didn't actually have to. Once I got it aligned, it was just going. Okay, there. It's the other one pushed in. And also just slide it in. No issue there, really. Okay, now I need to put the screws in to secure the pegs in place. So that's gonna be hard. Basically, it's just the there's a hole at the top of the pin, and then we're supposed to put. And then on the other side, we also have the same. Just that I don't want to lift it up, it might actually fall apart. Okay, is it possible to screw the screws too far in? Nope, so those can actually go in the whole way. I hope it doesn't split the part. Should I double? Do they have a as completed picture? They don't. No, it says tighten the screw to the surface part. To the surface of the part. So let's hope they're right. Okay. So. Oh, I wonder if you can see it. Yeah, it's a bit small, but you can see the screws there. So I tightened it right to the... Oh, there. It's a little bit more light on it. So you see it's to the surface. Now I'll do the same on the other side. Into the screw hole we go. Also, it still seems to open fine. Okay, next step, tensioners. So, here we go. two long screws, and then where are they supposed to go in? They are in here. In theory. Okay.
Screw it through.
Oh, that's a bit of alignment issues, I think. Okay. Okay. See that it's kind of coming through. I'll probably have to start this one also. To make sure we come out the other side. Oh, there we go. Stop. Whoa, that one went right through. As is intended. Okay, so this one is tight. Ah, okay. Oh, I freaked out. So, it's tightening up. Oh, so it doesn't really show how deep they should go, but I suppose we it's not taking yet. Oh, now it is. Okay, so I say that much for now. Okay, so that far so far so good. And always this like hurry the time. No wait, can't you look at the like check the main picture first. Let's see if it even looks like the. Okay, do we have any extra parts lying around? These are actually for the power box and that's that I'm not worried about. Okay, we got the extra blade. There's no extra parts here. Well, I used up all the parts from the part repository that I have. Looks at that kind of a picture angle, so something like that, I suppose. Well, I think it looks okay. Okay, so. Not bad, not bad. So, Haribo time for those that have Haribo still left. I'll get into my kids. So, okay. Wow, we did it. It's together. At least somewhat. Don't know if it works yet. Because there's even more to do. Yeah. So, you know, if you found this interesting, consider subscribing. Hit the bell icon. There's going to be more episodes in this series. Inform other people struggling to put this together or thinking about putting it together. And enjoy your Haribos if you have any. And see you in the next one.